Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to my channel, and in this episode I'm going to be covering the best pre-contract players to sign in career mode. These players are going to be ages between 23 to like 27, so these players are really good choices for mid-table teams and even some of the better teams. Anyway, let's just get into the video. The first player is going to be Pedro Biga, 77 rated, really decent pace and 89 aggression. You know, he's a really nice player from Spain, 5'11", quite small for a centre back, but he's one of the players that you can get for free. After that, we have Mario, the 6'2", plays for Bologna. You could also get him for free. After that, we have Konaka, plays for Wolfsburg, a really decent choice to get, especially he's 6'3" and he's really young. So, you know, I think he's got decent potential as well in this game, if I'm not wrong. You could also get him. Moving on, we have Mauro dos Santos, plays for Eibar in the Spanish league from Argentina. Really nice tackling, 84 slide tackle and 80 stand tackle. After that, we have Andre Pinto, a centre back, really slow and can't jump, but 91 strength, 6'4". So yeah, if you want a powerful beast in your centre back areas, you can get him. And onto the first left back, it's going to be my man Mattia Di Ciglio, the Italian international. This guy's got amazing potential, but in the recent years, he's kind of like not proving that wrong, but I kind of still believe in him because I'm a Milan fan. I think he still has what it takes. Really nice fullback. You can get him for free. Moving on to the midfielders. First, we have Yann Mvia. Look at them, physical, mental, and technical on the right side, guys. Not so much technical, but the mental attributes is exactly what you needed on a CDM. He's got a long shot taker trait as well, so, you know, it could be really useful when taking long range shots outside the box. So, from the France, you know all about Mvia. He played in the Premier League. Can play CDM, centre mid, and to get him on a free is really nice. After that, we have Jan Kirchhoff, the former Bayern Munich man. Really shit at balance, but in real life, I think he needs to read the game better because it's sometimes like his concentration levels are absolutely wank. So in the game, he's decent, I guess. 84 heading accuracy. I think he could play centre back here. Yeah. High defensive, low attacking work rate. Really decent player to get at 25 years of age. After that, we have Sidney Pacinho. I think he's a Brazilian. Yeah, Brazilian. High work rate. 6'2", 24 years old. He's also got a long passer and takes finesse free kick trait. So that's really nice. After that, we have Adrian Ragatin. I think he used to play for Toulouse, I think, but anyways, Moroccan international, 82 dribbling. You can't go wrong with getting him on a free. He's also got decent stand and slide tackling for a right mid as well, so, you know, you could potentially play right back. All of your players, like, injured and whatever. After that, we have Moroccan's Omar El Kadouri, plays for Napoli. Well, he never plays in real life, but you could also get him. 4-star weak foot. Technically decent, I guess you could say, but in real life, he's not that good, but in FIFA, you could. After that, we have Sebastian Rudy. Technically and overall, he's really nice. Can really versatile as well. We could play anywhere, and he's a really nice option to get, as you can see from the stats. Next, we have Mehmet Ekici, the Turkish international, 5-star weak foot, and as you can see from his trades, corner specialist, takes finesse free kick, so on a dead ball situation, free kick or whatever, he's really nice because, you know, you can literally do anything, takes corners, you know, he's such a playmaker, basically. 90 free kick accuracy, 85 shot power, 83 long shots, and 88 curve. Really great players to have in your mid. Literally, take corners with this dude and you will not regret. After that, we have Koo Jol-chung, the Kao South Korean international, double 4-star weak foot, 6 foot, 27 years old, kind of aging, but with them technical studs, you know, he's really nice. And moving on to the first striker, we have this guy, and look at that pace, literally speedster trait, obviously the Cameroon player, this next Samuel Eto'o. No, just kidding, but high attacking work rate, low defensive, so exactly what you need in a striker. He doesn't come back, you know, kind of waste his talents on playing up front, and he's also got 80 finishing as well, so he's really nice, cheap option to be fair, and to get him on a free, that's even better. He could be a backup player or even your first team player, so, you know, get this Benjamin Mukojando, or whatever it's called. Moving on to the second last striker, we have Seferovic, the Swiss international, high work rate. Not the best, not even the best striker to get, but, you know, he's on the list because, you know, you can just get him on free. Aggression, you know, he's one of them holding up the ball kind of player. Really low pace, but, you know, you could do much better with that Benjamin guy, in my opinion. And the last player to get in terms of pre-contract is going to be Silvio Romero. Plays for America. I don't think you can get him in the first transfer window, but you can get him in January for free because he's got 1-year contract with that club. So, you know, really nice pace, 4-star skills, high defensive work rate, which is quite shit, but you can obviously change that. But medium attacking, 5'9", agility is really nice, so he's gonna feel like Aguero mostly, and 75 finishing, so yeah, he's a really nice player that you can get for free, so, you know, try this guy out, guys. And guys, that's it. These are the players that you can get, and thanks for watching my video, and make sure to like and subscribe. I'm also going to be bringing out other FIFA career mode content, as you know, and yeah guys, if you've enjoyed the video, then make sure to subscribe. It actually does help me a lot. I'm kind of stuck at 20 or whatever at this point, so if you could actually subscribe, that's really nice. And anyway guys, thanks for watching, and Peace out. This episode I'm going to be covering this player called Mitchell Van Bergen. This guy's unbelievable. He's 16 years old. He's